The successor to the M1 iMac 24-inch, the M2 iMac 24-inch model is in development according to a new report. We have also been advised that we could also be getting 10 cores added to the M2 chipset that will make the new 2022 iMac around 40% faster than the M1 model. I want to go over specs, design, so really everything we know so far for the new iMac M2, and of course I also want to go over the iMac 2022 release date and price as well. But first, a quick summary of where we are with the iMac. So Apple updated the only remaining iMac in 2021 with a whole new design with a 24.5 inch display with the M1 chipset inside. The design is the thinnest iMac that has ever been created, and it's gone back to its old late 90s roots of adding lots of color choices that you can pick from. The iMac is a great home PC Mac for anyone who needs to browse the web or do some amateur photo, music or video editing, as the M1 chipset can more than cope with these tasks on an ad hoc basis. Well, we have some more great news, and that Apple are looking to enhance the new designed iMac with a couple of new features, and of course putting the next generation M2 chipset inside. So, we've just had the peak performance event, and lots of you were hoping for a more powerful 27-inch iMac to come alongside the 24-inch Mac, but we did kind of get this essentially with the Mac Studio. However, it turned out to be more powerful than we imagined, and it's also ticked all those boxes of being a replacement for the 27-inch iMac. Apple have also confirmed they're not going to be making the 27-inch iMac anymore, so this now means Apple only be making one iMac, what is the 24-inch model, but they have some big plans to change it in 2022. And one of those changes is the introduction of the M2 chipsets, what is the next generation version of Apple Silicon. And the first M2 chip will succeed the M1 chip. It will not be as powerful as, say, as the M1 Pro, M1 Max, or even the M1 Ultra, but it'll be more powerful than the standard M1, the chip that it's designed to replace. According to Bloomberg's Mark Gurman, the M2 expected to have the same 8-core CPU as the M1, but there will be speed and efficiency improvements, as it's expected to be built on TSMC's 4-nanometer process instead of the M1, what is on a 5-nanometer die. It will have the same 4 efficiency cores and also 4 performance cores inside, just for the CPU side of things. However, flipping over to GPU cores, and there's a big change for the M2. Instead, this time it's likely we're going to be getting between 9 and 10 GPU cores, up from the 7-8 core option that we had on the original M1 chip. These 2 additional cores, and also with that new 4-nanometer die, could mean we could get around about 30 to 40% more graphics power over M1. What is amazing, as M1 is more than capable at handling everyday graphics tasks at the moment. But with all of this, a quick note, with any of these leaks, even up to the new iMac release date, with all these reports and leaks, they're not 100% proof that they will come true with the new iMac. I can only present to you what I've been told and shown. However, if you are watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what is being said about the next iMac anyway. So, just quickly guys, this channel recently got over 350,000 subscribers, what's absolutely amazing. So in celebration of this, I am doing a giveaway right now on this channel for this. It is for a MacBook Air, and this MacBook Air here is the 8-core GPU option with 512GB of storage, and I'm going to be giving this away to one lucky subscriber when we get over 400,000 subscribers. And all you need to do to enter into this international giveaway is put down in the comments below of what Apple gear or what technology gear you're planning to buy in 2022. And when we get over that 400,000 subscribers marker, I'll be creating a video on this channel announcing who the winner is. So if you are new here, make sure to subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell right now. Now, just quickly, I do want to mention there are lots of scammers, there are lots of spammers, a lot of them impersonating myself, and they're telling you to WhatsApp you or to WhatsApp them or to Telegram them, ignore them completely or report them, because this is not me. Like you've heard from me here, I'll be making a video when we get over 400,000 subscribers announcing any kind of giveaway on this channel, and it will definitely be this time for this MacBook Air here. Well, with that out of the way, guys, let's return back to the video. So, moving on, release day is next, and the M1 journey in all Macs is near a close, with just the Mac Pro to be updated. It is likely Apple will want to start their journey again after the summer with putting M2 in the first Macs that got M1, that were the MacBook Air, the 13-inch MacBook Pro, and also the Mac Mini, and also the possibility of the new iMac. And it is likely that all four of these devices will be refreshed again this year. Apple will normally hold an event in September time that is more primarily for Apple's watches, iPads, and also the iPhones. However, we normally get another event around mid to end October time showcasing the new Macs that come out around about the end of October to early November time. It's expected for Apple to release the new M2 Macs at this time. So, with that out of the way, let's talk about the iMac specs along with the price. So, starting out, as already mentioned, the actual design is probably going to be staying the same for the iMac, just like we had with the M1 iMac that came out in 2021. But this basically means we'll be getting that same 23.5-inch LED Retina display, what we basically call is a 24-inch display. And the resolution of the display is a 4480 by 2520. This is a standard LED Retina display. It's not a mini LED display like in what we get in, say, the MacBook Pro, the 14-inch and 16-inch, and also that 12.9-inch iPad. So it's not going to be that. It's the same display as we've had before. But the great news is the pixels per inch will be 218. We'll have storage options between 256 gigabytes all the way up to 2 terabytes, depending on what kind of configuration that you pick. But the actual chipset inside it will be that brand new M2 8-core CPU, what is made up of 4 efficiency cores and 4 performance cores. And then you will also get the GPU, what will be up to 10 cores this time, 10 graphical cores, up from the up to 8 cores that we used to get in the M1 chipset. We will also get the choice between of 8GB or 16GB of RAM again, and the actual body will be an aluminium body, and then on the back we will have ports of either a choice of 2 USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports, or if you go for a higher configuration, you will get the 2x USB-C ports, what are USB 3, and you will also get those 2x Thunderbolt 4 ports, and you will also get a 1 gigabit Ethernet port, what's actually built into the power block, what you can like stick on the floor, for example. The colors will basically be the same again, and Apple could introduce a new color this year, so we'll have to wait and see on that. But the colors as they stand right now is blue, green, red, silver, yellow, orange, and purple. But like I said, they could introduce a whole new color, so we'll have to wait and see on that one. For the webcam, there's going to be a slight upgrade here. We're going to be getting a 1080p center stage camera now, because we do have the M1 chipset inside it and it can kind of handle sort of image processing bits and pieces. It makes sense for this to be upgraded to this. With price though, starting out with an 8GB of RAM configuration, and this is the lower spec M2 chipset, if you chose 256GB of storage, this will come in at $1,299, and then 512GB will be $1,499, and then, for example, 1TB would be $1,699. So, as you can see, Apple built the foundations of the M1 iMac and made it better here with the M2 iMac. So next are my wishes for the iMac M2, and really it's to do with the price. Right now the M1 iMac starts at $1,299, but I fear that Apple may actually increase the price this year by putting that M2 chipset inside it. I really hope they don't do this. They might slap on an extra $100, but I'm really hoping that the starting price will remain the same at $1,299 and it shouldn't increase at all. But those are my thoughts and wishes. Do you agree with that? Let me know in the comments below, because I'd love to know your thoughts. Well guys, it's also time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to press the like button, and at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, make sure you hit the subscribe button followed by that notification bell. Until next time guys, I will see you really soon.